Hi everybody, this is Gary Dean with Sentiment Timing, and this is our technical video report for Thursday, December 15th, 2022. The markets got kind of slaughtered today. They actually came off the lows a little bit, but it's kind of what I've been talking about, where, you know, you get these bulls that that have these algorithms that are programmed to read everything and just jack the markets up or down. And, you know, the CPI number came in. That was great. But is it a 3% move to the upside? No, it was a silly move. I didn't trust it. We did get long here, but I still didn't like the trade because we didn't really have any buy signals. So when I referred to this to our predictive analytics model, was where we had the we have time on our hand, but sentiment was not really let's just say confirming that we need to be buying, and we didn't really have a technical reason. So we had two kind of neutrals and one bullish, and that's really one of the reasons why I took this trade. But then when the Fed meeting came out, I had said that I don't really trust things. I didn't like this trade that much, but it could have gone up, and that's why I just wanted a little skin in the game. But once we got up to these levels, I said just put your stop at entry. And see what plays out. If Powell was said kind words to the market, then we would have seen, you know, the market flying higher. But again, it's just taking a step back and thinking, just trying to see 4 feet in front of you. Inflation's at 7.1%. So everybody, a majority, I would say there's more people that are professional traders that have never been in a recession or a bear market. So they're the only thing they're used to is the Fed giving easy money out and that just getting pouring into the market. That's gone. It's not coming back. They're going to be, a lot of these people will probably leave the business is what I'm thinking, because they're going to be dead wrong all the time. But the thing is this, is that we're in a time period now where it's still bullish. So on the predictive analytics model, we're still looking higher. Sentiment today is going to be probably washed down to 0 or 2%. And if you look here, I think we're going to need an up and a down, where I think we're probably going to come in someplace at the, you know, I wouldn't be surprised to see the 3,800 tested. And the reason why is that will give us, if we get the bounce somewhere up into the 3,941, then and we come down, that's where I believe that we'll get the bullish divergences. Now, we had them here, but the thing is, this move just got so powerful. So again, on a technical basis, we're neutral. But on the predictive analytics model, sentiment's going to be probably at extreme bearish readings. Time, it's seasonality, it's friendly to the bulls. And now we just have to kind of pick exactly where we want to start building a long position until we start hitting the Woody's turn date. So we are expecting a sloppy market. This is exactly what is playing out right now. I had originally put a buy at the 3870 level, and really the main reason was for the, you know, we had Fib support, and at the time we did have some bullish divergences. And we made it down to the 3877 and never filled that trade. So if I did, I wouldn't be 100% comfortable. But we've seen a lot of these moves really make lows without bullish divergences. So if we got a pop and we just come down and start testing these levels, I may just, you know, get some skin in the game and not try to be perfect, because I'm still on the side that we're going to come up and close this gap up at 4,200. And if we can build a pretty good long position anywhere between 3870 down to, let's just say, 3725 or a little bit lower, it's a lot of move to the upside. And we know how fast this market works. So I'm going to be patient with this. Like I said, if I end up missing this, then we'll just wait for this big, big swing trade, which is going to be to the downside. So the main things I'm really looking for right now is people just giving up on the Santa rally, which I believe we're going to start seeing that that's starting to take place right now. And really, the main reason is because all these people are trapped up here. As I mentioned, the market's a zero-sum game. For every buyer, there has to be a seller. So these people are getting washed out that we're expecting this market to go shoot straight up. Now we're getting people bearish on the market where if we get a bounce, they're going to short it. And I think they'll be right for a short time. But from there, they're going to hang on to it, thinking we're taking out these lows, and before we know it, we're going to be taking out these highs. So that's really it. I mean, I'm more on the side of looking to buy the dips. I kind of like things right here the way it is. That as far as a wave structure, one, two, three, this would be our four, even if we come up a little bit higher, anywhere from the 39.20 up to the 39.40. That would be our wave four, and then we make a wave five up. Now, if that's the case, then usually a bare minimum, we'd get anywhere from a 50 or a 78% retracement from wherever that low is. So that will accomplish our 100 plus point S&P say requirement that I look to make trades off of. And we're going to have a lot of things on our side supporting the rally that's anticipated. But like I said, I'm going to watch the pivots because there's a shot I may lower this. I'll put that all in the morning notes tomorrow. But right now, don't as Woody's been saying, as I've been saying, don't be scared of this market. This was a very important low that we made in October. And right now, I'm sorry, that's not even it. This is the 15-minute chart in October. And if you just look at this from the move from the lows to the highs, we're only at a 38% retracement. So a bounce up and then maybe going to a 50% retracement makes perfect sense before we head up, or we could even come down and do a 62% retracement. So I'm going to be keeping an eye on things. Again, short term, I kind of think that we're going to get a bounce because we do have some bullish divergences in place here. So I think we're going to do some backing and filling to the upside. And I'd really just keep an eye on the 39.38 and even up to the 39.68. So if they do, once we get up there, that will be our one, two, three, four, and then our five down. And that's going to be where we want to be buying because really the way that I'm looking at this is not going to be an impulsive wave to the downside. What it's I meant to the upside. What I'm really looking at is this being the A, this being the B, and wherever we make the low, and then coming up and making the wave C somewhere up into this level. But all that's going to be doing is just doing a little bit of a back test. The market's still in a bear market right now. So if we get up somewhere up into that 4,200 level, which is the open gap here, everybody's going to be bullish on this market again. And from there, that's when they're going to pull the rugs out. So there's going to be a lot of money to be made. Like I said, I think the patient end of things was the correct move. And right now, I'll keep throwing out my buy triggers and where I'm looking for things, and we'll just go from there. So with that, have a great night, and I'll talk to you guys in the morning.